my project's very unusual because it's autobiographical. That's not something I typically recommend. Also, it was very seat of the pen. So I did, 99% of the still photography and probably 70% of the video. So where I did collaborate with other people were at times when things were happening spontaneously. And I, you obviously don't want to disengage your body from the, from the things that you're doing. So at those times when spontaneous things were happening, I got help from, former students and colleagues. But, the vast majority of the project I photographed myself.
As far as budgeting goes with this type of project, how is that versus working in other typical media settings?
Well, documentary film is very expensive. So my situation was unusual. I just made the movie on a wing and a prayer that somehow I would get the post-production work accomplished. I knew the film could help people. So I began with working with a graduating student from a very good school in Florida called Full Sail. So, we worked together with the Final Cut work, for example. And we got it in pretty good shape. And then other post-production work, I worked with a very good studio. And they basically fronted me the work, hoping that they might get paid later, but they also believed in the humanitarian goals of the project. So sure enough, as time went on, as people started learning about the project, we eventually got very good funding from a family foundation. And it's been fortunate in this economy. So the film is on its way. It's out there. It's going to be on PBS nationally this fall. And we're giving away 10,000 copies. We're just beginning our national campaign this month. This is April 2011. So I hope to continue to fund the humanitarian giveaway program through sales of the film to libraries and institutions. I think documentaries are very effective. Documentaries are going through kind of a heyday these days. And, it's a wide genre. Some documentaries are documentary name only, and they're very, they're stylized, they're scripted, they're, almost anything but. But, my film is quite traditional in a documentary sense. It's just things as they're happening and trying to build a connection between the audience and my narrative and letting the story tell itself. That's a traditional documentary form. And you've got to believe. You've got to have something you want to say. You have to passionately believe in the story that you've just got to tell. And when there's a will, there's a way. You'll get it done. For me, it'd be hard to go back to day one because day one is all about the unexpected, life-changing, life-threatening diagnosis of cancer. So I'm not someone who looks back with regret. We're all very vulnerable, human, mortal people. And so I've never been a why me kind of guy. And so would I change anything? No, I wouldn't even change having been diagnosed with cancer and everything that goes with it as part of the ebb and flow of life. And you just got to live it. It's a gift being here. I close the film by saying every day is a blessing, every day is a gift. And it's true, I believe it. But just this past year, the Ford Foundation announced some very encouraging documentary funding initiatives. So documentary filmmaking is going through a generally positive time. Now, on the other hand, there aren't a lot of broadcast outlets. PBS is the strongest in the U.S., and as we all know, PBS funding is being threatened for, probably for political reasons, rather than for, it has nothing to do, in my opinion, with budget. And I think that's troubling because, PBS has made some mistakes, but they're much more apolitical than many media organizations. And why do I care about that? Because cancer is certainly apolitical. And most of what PBS does is just to get good work out there. I don't have any personal connection with PBS, but I think that if the government funding does dry up, private funding will continue to allow good filmmaking to be seen on PBS. Again, I've got no vested interest other than it bothers me that media shouldn't be politicized. And when you turn on the evening news at night, you need to believe who you're watching. And when the media is just all opinion, all pontificating, all yelling, and not enough strong reporting. It's troubling time, but I don't think PBS is really a major part of that problem at all. The problems of modern media are many, but I think it's a constant dumbing down process. People can appreciate and care about sophisticated content. I don't mean pretentious content, I mean content that matters. I encourage my students at the University of Florida to do work that matters. And at the same time, when the airwaves are filled with titillation, with escapism, with our personal time being occupied more and more with things like social media, which I also think is really cool, and I'm using social media, I think, powerfully to disseminate the message of this film. But, our lives are being sped up, and there's less and less time there to really receive important stuff that's part of what makes a democracy healthy. I think that the media does need to take a stronger leadership role that's not just driven by the almighty dollar. It used to be that news organizations and networks were kind of lost leaders for networks. It's not that way anymore. And the obviously, the product is suffering. And sometimes our viewers and our readers are they're not ignorant people in any way, but they're ignorant of the fact that they're not getting a broad cross-section of information, unless there's a world crisis or something like that. And I just think that, the up-and-coming generation of journalists, the wonderful students here at OU and other schools that are stronger journalism too, you're going to be the saviors of the industry, because if you can wait for content, the technology is going to take care of itself, and people will give a darn if you present high-quality work to them. At the University of Florida, 4 years ago, I initiated what we call the Media Initiative for Social Responsibility. And I'm teaching courses, based on that. So I'm someone that just believes content. It doesn't mean it always has to be heavy or dark or deep. You need a healthy mix of upbeat and also to do reporting on some of the things that are problems in our society that need to change. And I think it's the same thing with journalism students. If they're just fed nothing but bits and bytes on how you gather information, you disseminate information in almost a database-like way, then creative thinking suffers. If you talk to people about the importance to tell stories and again, to give a damn, then journalism will continue to attract the kind of people who really care, who care about credibility, who care about fairness, and are the eyes and ears of a free society. So I'm generally positive, but I think we need stronger leadership in media to not just go to the lowest common denominator. Of course, it's a problem now. My film is multifaceted. I'm now 2 years into this process, and we're just beginning our national PR launch this month. Again, if people are watching this later, it's April 2011. So we're very excited about what's to come. We'll be airing nationally on PBS for beginning September 2011 for at least 2 years. And then we have medical education goals for the film for medical humanities education. And so there's a lot to do. I feel like it's really just starting. And in terms of personal and professional goals, just to basic stuff, try to continue to be a good person, be a good role model for my kids and my students, of course. The future's bright.